We've never seen an overreach like this, certainly not in my lifetime. I'm guessing not in yours, where government arbitrarily, there are no numbers to back up why small businesses are still closed. My goodness, there were no numbers in the beginning as to why a gym was labeled non-essential. How's that even possible? Physical therapy open, gym closed. And now we're getting into a point where you've got literally tens of thousands of small businesses across this area, from here to New York, from the city and beyond. And there is no end in sight because there's no plan for these small businesses. So one business in particular, business owner, taking it upon himself, saying, no, you know what? I'm opening for business today. His name is Bobby Catone. He spent his summers growing up on the Jersey Shore and now owns two tanning salons on Staten Island. He's open at 11:30 today. Bobby, welcome to New Jersey 101.5. How are you?
Hey, Bill. How are you? Thanks for having me.
Good, man. I appreciated the conversation we had yesterday. I'm going to post that conversation to our website, nj1015.com/Bill Spadea. But I wanted you to just talk to folks about why it's got to this point, right? You are just going to open your doors. Enough is enough.
Just going to open up at 11:30. We have a huge support group. All the media is going to be there just by word of mouth. I guess we hit a nerve somehow with small businesses and what's going on.
So your shops, you own two. It's called Sunbelievable is the name of the salon. And you're already, just as our conversation yesterday, I'll just share with everybody, it's already socially distant. Even if we had to buy into that, which I don't, but I know that businesses are going to have to do something to accommodate what these government mandates are. But the reality is your salon is already socially distant. You've got, what, six different bays in each of your stores?
Eight, actually, yes.
Eight. So you've got people coming in. They're going to be responsible. They're going to be distant. And they just want to get that base tan so they can get out to the beach at some point over the weekend. What is the response you got when you posted that you were going to open?
Overwhelming. Insane.
Yeah.
Like, people are happier than I am. There's more to it than just tanning, Bill. People do it for other therapeutic reasons.
Yeah.
Depression is a big factor when it comes to staying in this long, and vitamin D, which you get from indoor outdoor tanning, boosts your immune system, boosts your SAD, seasonal affective disorder, so you don't get depressed in the during this whole process.
You need that light.
It's very important, very, very important. People don't realize it is the most important vitamin / hormone in your body. And being that we're in the Northeast, we don't get the right amounts of UV light. So probably 99% of us are UV deficient. I'm sorry, vitamin D deficient in the winter months.
Yeah. So let me ask you this, Bobby. What do you expect? You've got a lawyer. You know that there are a ton of business owners and folks that are going to just show up in the parking lot today. What do you expect to happen? Do you expect that you're going to get shut down by the cops, or do you expect that you're going to be left open for business?
That's probably the $64,000 question. We hope for the best, right?
Yeah.
I think personally, if we do it in a peaceful way, which I promoted,
mm-hmm.
And we made it very clear out there that they might come in and say, you know what, do it the right way, and we'll see what happens. Let trust us.
Yeah.
Trust small business to do what we've been doing for me for 25 years, for most people, many years. Why could you trust a big box store with hundreds or thousands in a day and employees, and you can't trust a small business with one or two employees and 5 or 10 people throughout a few hours? Makes no sense. You have to trust us. We trusted you. Time to trust us.
Now, you and I talked about this a little yesterday, and you know, it's like everybody did what was largely accepted as the right thing to do. Let's flatten the curve. Let's not overwhelm our healthcare facilities. All these things. And in New York and New Jersey, we literally had to fold up the shop because most of the beds, the hospital beds, the ICU units, the ventilators weren't even used. So for whatever it's worth, it happened. It peaked. Here we are now almost in June. And what are you being told by the government that why you're still shut down?
That's another $6,000. That's the $128,000 question.
Yeah.
How
right.
about that?
Yeah.
Listen, but Bill, if they gave us a date, some kind of an a permanent or a tentative or a guaranteed date, we could plan. How do you plan? How do you say to your fiance, yeah, we're going to get married, we'll figure it out as we go along?
Yeah.
You know, you have to have a date. You have to plan. This is a business doesn't work day by day. A small business plans weeks, months in advance. You can't just say, all right, you figure it out, and then we have to pay our own bills for all this time. Not just every business, every household is having an effect. It's a whole trickle-down effect. This is insane. It doesn't even make – you know, if they came to us and said, shut down for 2 weeks, and then anything after that, we'll pay your bills for you. Don't worry about it. They're not doing that.
No.
I don't see any government official saying, I'm going to donate my check to the local food pantry. I'm going to follow.
Right.
I'm going to lead by example. Nobody doesn't. The captain go down with the ship. That's what I was. How I was taught.
You know, Bobby, I was raised that way too. And you've got these governors still collecting a handsome salary, and a raise. Good. You see, they just raised the tolls on the Turnpike and the Parkway. Like it's madness out there. They're expecting the little guy to continue to pony up. And you're being hurt. So listen, good on you. I'm so glad that we met. And I'm able to talk about this story. Your tanning salon is called Sunbelievable. How'd you come up with that term? I love it.
25 years ago, sitting on the Manasquan Beach with my friends, drinking beers. You were allowed to drink beers on the beach back then.
Yeah.
You know, you daydream and say, what are we going to do? We're young, you know, mid-20s. What are we going to do? We were all always successful in whatever we did, but we wanted to live an American dream. So we're trying to figure out. All my friends ended up becoming successful, by the way. What could I do? Because I was a manager at Pathmark for 15 years prior. So I said, why am I making other people rich, working 40 hours a week, getting an hourly wage? So let's come up. How about tanning salon? I've never even been to one. So that takes a big risk to even open up a business you've never been to. I said, we got to come up with a name. And it literally, within seconds, I said, sun is out here. That's pretty unbelievable.
I love it.
Beer, it wasn't even trademarked. I was amazed.
That's amazing, right? I love it. Beer and Manasquan. It leads to a lot of good things. All right, Bobby, listen, good luck today. So 11:30, you're opening. And so tell me what location is opening today. It's Sunbelievable Salon. What location's opening up at 11:30?
4255 Amboy Road in Great Kills, Staten Island.
Great Kills, Staten Island. Outstanding. So if you need to get a tan today, you know where to go. Should they go to the website to set up an appointment or call you? What do you want people to do?
They have to call. We're by appointment only. We did change our guidelines to make sure we meet everything. So we minimized our appointments for the day, spread them out, and lowered our open hours throughout our regular daily hours. So we're booked today, believe it or not. People called. We were booked.
I love it.
We were booked within minutes.
I love it. Well, look, stay in touch, Bobby. I'm going to post all the information so people know how to get in touch with you on my website. And please let me know how it goes today. Let's check in over the next couple of days. All right?
All businesses are essential.
All businesses are essential. I'm with you 100%, Bobby. Good luck today.